upwards. So another good example of increasing friction in order to reduce the work and increase the efficiency. Let us also look at the concept of ideal machine. What is an ideal machine? As we saw in all the previous examples, friction is always present throughout nature. Nature has given this as a boon if you can use it well. If you are not aware of how to use friction, it increases your work. So even if you lubricate, you know, how do you slip on a motorbike when you are going on a road? Number one, when there is heavy rainfall and the surface is wet. Number two, there is oil spilled on the road, and so you lose all control over your brakes and your bike goes crashing, you go crashing. That is this lubrication. Even if you lubricate it 100% and or do anything to construct as smooth a surface as you can, there will always be some amount of friction. It is impossible to make friction zero. But let us assume you have been able to do that. If you are able to reduce friction to zero, then a machine or any process where there is no friction, or it is so small that it can be neglected, is called an ideal machine. We have yet to discover such ideal machines because there are always real machines. Real machines always have to face friction. It is there whether you can use it to advantage or whether you cannot use it to advantage. So the concept of ideal machine is a benchmark where there is no friction and therefore there is 100% efficiency and work is minimum. But let us look at real machines. Machines have sliding parts. Friction will always be there. When there are any two surfaces which are sliding against each other, there is always friction. So real machines always have to overcome friction. That is our entire discussion. Friction is always there. Most of the time you want to reduce friction because it involves additional work, it involves loss of energy. Now this loss of energy can be in many different forms, in the form of heat, wear and tear of machines, etc. So ideal machines have to be designed so that friction is minimized. Types of friction: dry friction, fluid friction, also called Coulomb friction. When unlubricated surfaces are in contact or in sliding conditions, we will encounter dry friction. In this case, the direction of the friction force is always opposite. If your sliding is in this direction and this is your surface, your friction is going to be in the opposite direction. The other kind of friction is the fluid friction. As we saw in case of the pipes, the pipe has a surface, but within the fluid also there are layers, and each layer is going to exert some amount of friction. The study of this kind of friction within fluids is done in the subject of fluid mechanics. Here particularly we shall be studying only problems on dry friction. We will not be touching fluid friction. How to analyze equilibrium of rigid bodies? Assuming that there is always dry friction on the surface. So the examples that we are going to study on dry friction are going to be ladder. For one, everyone has seen a ladder, everyone has used a ladder. Say this is a wall and there is a bookcase here. You want to reach the topmost shelf of the bookcase. What will you do? You will put up a ladder. What will happen? even without knowing any concept of friction, even without understanding what friction is, how friction can be resisted, everybody knows that if after a certain angle the ladder will, what will happen? This will start going here, this will start going here, the ladder will slip off. Therefore, you have to adjust a very good angle to have the ladder in place. What is happening here? There is friction between these two surfaces, the surface of the ladder and the wall. There is friction between this surface and the floor. So here is a classic example of how friction is in our day-to-day lives in the machines. Another example, as you already saw, wedges, screws, belts and rope friction. Dry friction. We once again come back to our original body. This body will be having its own self weight due to the gravity. That is going to be W. We already know that that will be resisted by a normal force acting in the direction exactly opposite to W. So this is what we have studied so far. Since there is no horizontal force on this particular body, the surface too does not need to exert any horizontal force because his body is stationary. It is just lying there. Nothing is happening to the body. There is no activation of friction. When will friction be activated? Only when two surfaces try to slide over each other. Whenever motion is attempted between two surfaces, friction is going to come into picture. In this case, there is no friction as yet. So let us complicate our problem. You have W, you have your normal force N, but now I am trying to push it. Push it with a certain force P. Immediately between these two surfaces, there is a friction force which comes into picture. So we talk about W, we talk about N, we talk about P, the external horizontal force, and we talk about the friction force F. What is happening? If this were not existing, let us assume for 1 minute that force F was not existing, friction was not there, we do not know anything about the concept of friction. Then in that case, when you apply P, the body should move. As soon as you apply, because it is not in equilibrium, the body should move, isn't it? What is happening? It is not moving. The block is stationary. In fact, if you just touch this body, even with your hand, there is some force you are applying, which is not balanced, but the body is not moving. That means some other horizontal force exists which is balancing your external horizontal force. This other force is the static friction force F. So far it is only static. It is resisting. It keeps on resisting. Till what point will it resist? Supposing you keep on increasing P. P1, P2, keep on increasing P as much as you can. Finally, after certain point, after certain value of P, the body will slightly move forward. What happens then? Because the surface, the roughness of these two surfaces, this and this, which was generating the frictional force F, is now no more able to balance P. Frictional force due to the roughness is less as compared to the external horizontal force that is being exerted. So, there came into picture this concept of friction. Friction is actually, if we see, the resultant of a number of forces acting over the entire surface of contact. Here I have given a very simple example. This is only a horizontal force and therefore friction is horizontal. Let me complicate it more. Probably it is there in the next slide. No, it is not. Had I applied a force like this, incline, there will also be a resultant force which is inclined. What will be the component of that resultant force? This component will be added to your W and will be resisted by your normal force N. This component will be resisted by your static friction F. So, we have to remember that this is the resultant of a number of forces acting over the entire surface of contact between the two bodies, the block and the plane. This is a very important sentence. We can analyze, we can find out the actual value of friction, but what is it in nature? What is it in the roughness of the surface? What is it in the nature of the surface of this body and this block that is generating friction? Scientists have done various experiments to find out friction, but the nature and cause of these forces is not yet known fully. It is assumed, we are just assuming that it is caused by the roughness of the surface. And to a certain extent, some molecular attraction between the two surfaces, that is the surface of the body and the surface of the plane. But that is an assumption. There is as yet no scientific foolproof theory what causes friction. But we have gone ahead and we have also found out all the methods of calculating friction. Come back again to our main problem. You have the self weight W, you have the normal force N, there is an external horizontal force P. Now, as we saw in the last slide, we keep on increasing P. The body is not going to move. That means the friction is able to resist P. There is one single instant, one point beyond which P will increase to such an extent that body will move. The point where the movement is just about to start is the point when friction is exceeded. So, if we P is increased till the block just begins to slide, just started, just motion start nahi thi, but it just begins to slide, the friction will keep on increasing till it reaches its maximum value Fm. This is the maximum or limiting friction. We can call it, the technical term is limiting friction. Definition of limiting friction. Limiting friction Fm, let us call it Fm, that is the maximum friction, is defined as the maximum friction that a surface will offer when another surface tries to slide over it. The maximum friction it will keep on offering till this point is crossed, that is limiting friction. So, just at the point when the surface starts to slide, the instant, the moment and the point where the surface starts to slide over the other, Fm has suddenly dropped. Fm has reached its maximum value, it cannot increase anymore, it cannot resist the horizontal force anymore, and therefore Fm suddenly drops. Look at this graph. If we keep on checking, what happens? P is increasing, 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 F is increasing, 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 and therefore we get this line. At one instant, there is motion. The body slides. The moment the body slides, there is a sudden drop from Fm to a value Fk. That means the type of force, the frictional force, is now not Fm, not the limiting friction, not the maximum friction. It is somewhat less. It has reduced. The point of maximum static friction has been crossed, which is called kinetic friction, Fk. Here we are going to study the concept of limiting friction. Let us try to understand how to find out. As I said, the exact nature and cause of friction is left again to the scientists who keep on studying the surfaces, the molecular attraction, etc., etc. But we have to go further, because we have to remember, we have to design all those machines, all those gears, all those wedges, all those ladders. Everything depends on friction. You want to control your friction. So we want to find out how to calculate friction. So once again, experimental evidences. Science has always had theoretical backgrounds along with experiments. If both of them give you the same results, then you have certain equations which can be used in engineering. Now, experimental evidence shows that static friction, the maximum value, as we said, Fm, is proportional to the normal force N when the motion of the body is just about to start. The motion when it is just about to start is called, this is just terminology, you need to understand this terminology, is called impending. It is just language. English language says the point when the motion of the body is about to start is called impending motion. At that particular point, the equation of friction Fm is equal to mu s into n. Remember n, what is n? Everywhere all along we have seen n. Now here we have found out, thankfully, that you can relate friction to n. How? By a parameter mu s. What is mu s? It is called the coefficient of static friction, and therefore the word s. Coefficient of static friction belongs to the nature of the surface. Whatever the nature of the surface, it is going to have a very specific. If you have wood, it has a certain coefficient of static friction. If you have plastic, it has a certain set of coefficient of static friction. Concrete, another set of coefficient of static friction. Once you know what kind of surface and what kind of roughness, you will have your mu s. You also have your force N. Remember, force N is that normal force always generated equal and opposite to your self weight. So now it becomes very simple for us to find out your friction. Fm is equal to mu s into n. We also need to define the coefficient of static friction. Coefficient of static friction is defined as what? You already know what it is. The ratio of the limiting friction. What is limiting friction?